finger flick.
You're allowed to show up.
This team is ruining my life.
I'm taking crazy pills.
With you, wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Can we get some noise for the first LFR of the season? Let's go. Book launch for Hockey Rants and Raves here at Greta. Okay, that's enough. Thank you, but shut up. No. We're here at Greta. It's a book launch. I'm so excited. It's the first game of the season. It's the first game of the Craig Berube era. It's the first game of the Steven Lorenz era or something. And the Leafs celebrate it by getting shut out in an NHL record style. Leafs lose. Wow. It's really participatory, and they're also very used to it. Leafs lose 1-0 at the hands of the Montreal Canadiens. I led with it. A lot of people in this room are going to find it out for the first time. Sam Montembeault just set a record for the most saves in a shutout to start the season with 47. Now, how you feel about all this and how you feel about this game depends entirely on your level of trauma and your tolerance for that trauma increasing. They had over 40 shots. They had nearly 50 shots. Is that good?
Yeah!
We like that. They allowed under 30 shots. Is that good?
Yeah!
We like that. They got shut out in the first game of the season. Do we like that? Joseph Woll's out. Do we like that?
No.
They start the season with a back-to-back, and it's against Sheldon Keefe of the Devils on the second half of it. Do we like that?
Yeah.
Well, see, a few of you are like, yeah, that's awesome. That's a lot of fun. And I agree, it is a lot of fun. It is especially more fun if you win the first one. Yeah. Because do you understand what we're walking into? I'm not saying I'm going to do it. I'm not saying, I feel like Tim Robinson in the hot dog suit. We're all looking for the guy who did this right now. But if tomorrow, second half of a back-to-back against one of the most high-octane offenses in the entire NHL, is Dennis Hildeby's debut, he gets shelled. Joseph Woll is out. They get shut out again. Who even knows? They begin the season 0-2. And oh, by the way, they begin the season with 3 games in 4 nights. Do we like that?
No.
No! I'm glad you were keeping track. That was a lot. That was a lot. But overall, was tonight a bad game?
No.
Yes, why?
They got shut out by Montembeault!
See? And both reactions, I think, are perfectly valid and reasonable. On one hand, you go, ah, they got goalied. Ah, we had 47 shots. They had 27. They had an unbelievable goalie. It's our first game, new coach, blah, 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 blah. Those are all luxuries that you afford the Florida Panthers. You can't even hurt my feelings. I saw someone talk about the $7 million cap hit for Carter Verhaeghe being too much. And I'm like, if it was 13, I don't know if Panthers fans would care. They just won the cup. They are on one. Their rings has the WWE logo in it. They're feeling great about themselves. And what sunk the Leafs tonight was one power play goal. One from Cole Caulfield. No. No woo. No woo.
It's nice that he's wearing 13.
And it? Yeah. But like, he sunk the team and it made me feel sad. But also, that's very apt. That was very good. So it's funny. I came into this going, there's going to be too much to summarize in this video with a live audience. It's going to be 6-5 in overtime. It's going to be an absolute shooting gallery. The way it always is in a season opener. And what they gave me was one goal, and it wasn't even for the team that I cheer for. So that made me a little upset. Who did I say was going to score the first goal of the season for the Leafs? Does anyone remember? Steven Lorenz, and he might have come the closest out of anyone, except for Matthews hitting the crossbar. That made me very sad. Every single Leaf on the roster had at least one shot on goal tonight, except for David Kampf, which tracks. You know, I'm not, it's not an insult, but it is a little bit. Lorenz was in there. Reeves was in there. Marner had a really interesting steal that was sort of dangerous there at the end. Matthews was flying. Matthew Nyes. Right? He was bullying guys off the puck. There were a lot of things to like about that. And I think any reasonable fan knows that. Are we in a room full of reasonable fans?
No!
They have one series win in the Matthews, Marner, Nylander era. Should we be reasonable?
No!
Right? So you sort of see the back and forth and back and forth and how interesting the beginning of this season is going to be. Now, I mentioned Dennis Hildeby. People thought Wool was starting tonight when they woke up this morning. And all of a sudden, Elliot Friedman tweets, he might be out. He is out. Oh, he's on IR, which means he needs to miss at least a week. Not LTIR, but IR. So hopefully it's not that serious. But Hildeby is going to get into games. That is going to be a story. Stallers is officially the starter for the time being. That is going to be a story. And I think that's the positive coming out of this game. There was a different play style, a lot of shots from the back end, which they weren't really doing before. Western Conference style hockey. That's a note from producer Drew. What do we think about him? I love that because everyone's like, that's a valid point, but I hate him. That's very valid. We were talking during the show. I think everyone's anxiety coming into tonight was not that the Leafs would get shut out, because this is the first time in 227 games since November 2021 that the Leafs got shut out. And you all got to be here for it. Isn't that so sick? Oh, I'm so happy about it. But that's not what you were worried about heading into this game. You were worried about Joseph Woll being out. Right? You were worried about the goalie of the future, maybe, sort of. They sign him to a 3-year contract that doesn't kick in until next year, by the way. Everyone's doing LTIR math right now in their head and doing it poorly because it's hard. It's really hard to understand. But I think the shutout shouldn't cloud how good Anthony Stallers was. There is nothing like the comfort of having a great goalie and a goalie who gives you a chance to win every single game. And right now we have no reason whatsoever that to suspect that Anthony Stallers is not that guy. The only thing he didn't do tonight, besides not get a 47 save shutout, was score a goal. And that's okay because nobody on the team scored a goal. But first time in 227 games. Do we think that's going to happen again? This is the reaction I was looking for. This guy right here, who's like, yeah, I mean, probably not, but it's the Leafs. It's the Leafs, right? We have come to expect the worst thing that could happen will happen. But I don't think that's what happened tonight. I'm optimistic for the rest of the season, and I'm going to say that until I believe it. Do we have questions?
Okay, hi. So, it's been a really, really long time since the Leafs have been shut out. It's also been a really, really long time since they won a cup. So I'm saying, good thing?
Yeah! That's a good, yeah! Yeah, for sure. That's a good thing. One more. What's up?
What do you think Craig Berube's impact on the team? How is Craig Berube hockey different from Sheldon Keefe hockey?
Ooh. So we started by talking about, I think he brings a little bit of Western Conference hockey, more shots from the back end. They played pretty heavy tonight. One thing that I think he is going to scream the paint off the wall for, you had 47 shots and you didn't even get a greasy one. Like, a lot of shots were going on. There were a ton of muffins to the chest. And one thing Sheldon Keefe said for half a decade, hopefully Craig Berube can get through this team, is go to the net! Because that is where goals are scored. But, folks, I've been getting the wrap it symbol from Jesse for a while now, so I'm going to do that. That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really like to tell all your friends. I wrote another book! And with you wherever you are, welcome to LFR!
Go Leafs, go! 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 Go Leafs, go!
I forgot to include this part in the LFR, but someone named Jason said that if the Habs win, I have to call the LFR Lane Hudson is my dad, or Hudson is my dad, so I'm going to do that. But he said in return, he'll donate $150 to my Easter Seals team. So congrats, Jason.